Chicano movement and how much it's influenced who we are, as well as the uprising of the Zapatistas and the intersection of those two movements in different eras, and how they've shaped how we look at the world and continue to look at the world. So we named our collaborative project, both the collaborative project that we have with each other, as well as the collaborations that we do with community-based organizations, Dignidad Rebelde, in the spirit of the Zapatista.
I think one of the things that a lot of people see is the work that we do, like maybe for a rally, when we make posters with an organization for a rally or a march or something, and we're giving away posters, a lot of people see that. But we also do a lot of the prints, like the work that's in this exhibit. We have a lot of prints that we do that are portraits or more something that would be considered fine art. And even to the point that we work with other artists, we team up with an artist and we'll publish their work. So that means that we really believe in the artist, so we'll ask them to create something, to design a print, and we'll work with them to actually print it and produce an edition, and we'll split that with the artist. And so these are the many roles as the Dignidad that we take, which for us is something that we see as really unique, because a lot of times you have people who are doing one of these things, and we're really taking a lot of different things, which allows us to be very unique in a sense. And so for us, that's one of the things that we really draw in the history of Chicano art, not just in one of those ideas that they had, which was, you know, making art for the people in the streets, or making these fine art prints, or working with artists, but we try to take all those things and really make them part, very, very central to the work that we do.
So I think, to me, Sisters at the Center captures really succinctly the spirit of globally, the way that women should be at the forefront of movements to change the world, because they're the most economically disadvantaged, the most impacted by multiple oppressions, by war. They are a huge labor force that usually isn't given its just reward for the labor that they're producing. And so a principle of organizing is that they be at the lead of the change, so that they should always be at the center of the principles, the goals, and the change that we want to see. So I think because of the way that our work reflects a lot of different movements, that partners with a lot of organizations, it's no accident that the majority of our work reflects those women. So I think having an intentional space where we elevate their images is really a wonderful thing to be able to look at. Thank you.